The wife and Eunice went to together. So when Eunice was going through it all, they were there, wakamshikilia, wakamleta hapa. Then this is Baba Kimani. Sasa hii ndo tumekuwa tunang'ang'ana nao. So ni hawa wawili. And then the dog and madak, dog ni watatu. Ndio wamekuwa kimando. Yes.
Okay. And also the policy of the photographer.
Okay. Here ama huko?
After hapa
kusikitwe. Oh, after hapa iko sawa. So tumalize saa hii ama tunini baadaye? Aya, wacha tumalize saa hizi. So mko sawa?
Yeah.
Shot iko sawa ama tusonge? Mnatakaje?
Said come through for him. Nini likupush?
Boy child, man. Nobody cares about boy child. But I'll be the first one. So I'm starting. Then Mheshimiwa Sonko has joined me. Baba Kimani has joined me. Lawrence has joined me. And you guys have joined me. So lazima mtu aanze. We have very many agencies looking after girl child. But boy child is being ignored. And without the man in the society, there's a lost society. So I decided, because everybody was sharing pictures and videos of Kimani. People, oh my God, it's Idieni. This is so bad. Oh my God. Others making fun of him. Others clicking, posting for views. But it's not going to change anything. So I decided to be the change that I want to see. And that is why we're here.
And how do you feel when you see people trying to criticize you and asema, as much as Obin and Asaidia,
yeah,
why should he record?
Okay, the reason why we're recording basically is for accountability. Number one, we were raising money, so people have to know where the money is going. Secondly, for awareness. If we don't record, there's another boy in Kisumu, in Mombasa, in Kikuyu, anywhere, who might be going through the same problem, who or also might be having friends when you're zafanya inge the same problem. If you don't record, they'll not know. What we're doing, basically, we are disseminating information. Tumekamu, tumefika, tukambia, eh, Kimani had an alcohol problem or had a drug problem or had this. When you talk about it, it makes you talk about it, makes them talk about it. Namana kwa, eh, mumeona, ebu tusijaribu. But if you don't talk about it, kwa tuzi lapana. For example, my youth sema, eh, bangi. No, bangi simbaya. Boru naipiga kome meditate, ume relax, ume shiba, nini, nini. But ugekana Baba Kimani, he thinks different because he has seen different. But if he didn't talk about it, kwa tuzi linyaje, meditation, bro. Unapiga yako polite na relax. Ikilipukia umse, zake nzuka zimemshika tu. But ujaingia hapa ndani ya hospitali. We were there last time with Baba Kimani. What we saw there, a lot of young people. Unambiwa drug, drug, drug. See you here?
Yes,
you know. True. Majority wako hapa because of?
Drugs.
Which drug?
Bangi,
alcohol, cigarette, chavis.
Even
Mira.
So is this a movement you're starting to help?
Yes, I am beginning a movement and I'm hoping that wanaume wote watanijoin, because wanaume si uko na ile shida ya kuchekeleana kama sio yako. But wanasemangu ukiona mwenzako ananyolewa, chako lifanye vipi?
Tia maji.
Wanaume si kwa zile niaje, the same way, and I always talk about gender-based violence and mental wellness. And I always say gender-based violence, si mwanaume tu kupiga dem, ni pia dem kupiga mwanaume. Basa ya tukena mtani, leo mini kipiga kofi na dem. Wasiwa na nchekila, semi chiki wenye anapigwa na dem. But mini kipiga dem kofi, everything goes to. So that's what I'm talking about. For wanaume tuanze kuongea, tuanze kusema si pia ni binadamu. We also need the attention, we need the support, we need the love, we need the care. And we also need the information to know what is wrong. We are not perfect. We are human beings. We make mistakes. But if I talk about it, and if I'm going through a problem, you don't laugh about it. You don't laugh at me, but unakama unambia ni bro, eh, hapa umpotea kidogo, tusonge hivi kidogo, we are going to have a better society. So it's a movement and I'm hoping that we'll walk the journey together.
Tunaweza sikia from Mheshimiwa.
Yes.
Mheshimiwa, my name is Leon Bibigu from Nation. Before President Uhuru Kenyatta left, we used to have a mental health task force,
yes,
which is no longer functioning, number one. Number two, the Ministry of Health, Department for Mental Health, does not even have a head. He resigned. We even
down the line, and I'm still taking good care of that particular baby. So this is the same case, the reason why I'm here. Obina raised Imani Mbogwa's case, and our sister Eunice. I'm here to do a thorough follow-up on that. We promise to clear the medical bills and maybe transfer the patient to another rehabilitation center in Mombasa. By that, I don't mean that Mathare doctors hawajafanya kazi, no. No. Wamefanya kazi. Actually, tumesikia from the dad that Kimani Mbugua is due for discharge in a week's time. So, kumaanisha ana improve na chance yake anaendelea mzuri. Our sister Eunice, pia we have heard she's due for discharge today. So, labda pia kwenda mahali kuna conditions of environment, pia inasaidia kwa hii magonjwa. Mimi nataka kusema pia I had this condition before, bipolar condition. Ni kama hereditary factor in our family. My daughter also had it, but tumeendelea na medicine. My doctor is a psychiatrist called Dr. Kigamwa. So what tunaenda for checkups and everything. So hii si kitu ya kufanya PR nayo ama kuenjoy wale watu wana undergo that particular condition. No. Hiyo condition unakula dawa vizuri na kufuata vile doctors wana psychiatrist wanakuambia you'll be okay. As well as a patient ya bipolar. So we are here also to encourage the family, babake Kim, family ya Eunice, wakuwe strong. These are common things, this normal part of our daily life.
And Mheshimiwa, you are expected for running for any political seat, but despite all that, you still have you see the kindness to help people. Maybe can you tell us what drives you to be kind to people and also to give to the community?
Okay, I'm not here for politics. Remember 2027, because I don't want to, I'm capitalizing on the situation right now at the moment. I'm not talking about politics. That is, we always say God's time is the best in politics. So when 2027 reaches, tutajua. But for now, let's deal with the issue of patients. Don't let us not politicize this issue of our patients. We are here to fulfill the promise that I made during the Edibas show. This guy is Sonkoni, leader of PR, I'm a leader of Vipindre. I'm not here from Vipindre. I'm here to help. So for another forum, I'll be able to answer that. But for now, let's deal with the issue that has brought us here.
Now, Obina, yep. I have a question for you, considering you're a seasoned journalist. Eh?
Okay.
Actually, I was Obina's intern.
Yeah.
Yes. So, Obina, borrowing from Kimani's lesson, are we as journalists in our line of work prone to mental health and substance abuse issues?
Yes,
because
we are.
There's been that discussion that we are not really talking about.
Mm-hmm. Yes. So journalists are, let me use the word high risk, because of the work we do. We work under so much pressure. Like today morning, I think I posted this thing about 10 minutes to the time we're here, but I'm getting, I'm finding people at the gate. I'm like, oh, you're okay. So that was too quick. That's too pressure. Then people expect you to deliver. And the journalists, journalism life, we are, me and you are coming from radio and newspaper and TV. We know the pressure that was there from your bosses to everybody to deliver. And then sometimes the remuneration is not worth the whole hassle. Then also backlash online. People expect you to live a certain way. They forget that journalists are also just human beings. So sometimes, you know, when a man lacks purpose, they distract themselves with pleasure. So that's why you find umevutwa job ama una hustle ama wiki yote hujapatiwa any report kufanya ni nini, what do you do? Unakunywa wapi? Acha nipitie base. Unapiga jaba wapi? Acha nipitie base. So we distract ourselves with pleasure, then now bad company inaendelea leo kesho, then unajipata umeshakuwa addict na umezoea, and now that one leads into other things as well. So journalist A1, and also we have other careers.
Tuko sawa.
Hapa Kimani, songeni hapa. How are you? Haya, leteni maswali. Nimewaletea mheshimiwa hapa. Baba Kimani yuko hapa.
Yeah.
Lawrence yuko hapa. Your wife?
No, She's my friend, my partner, got to work.
Okay. Yeah, so let me maswali, because now after here, we'll not be allowed to record because of the hospital's policy and the privacy for the other patients and other families. Swali ya kwanza.
Okay, kuna wasee pale kwa mtandao anasema hili nyenye Kimani Mbogo ana go through.
Yes.
Inaweza kuwa yani for life time inaweza kuwa ngumu sana kwa hiyo. Maybe unaweza tuambia chikusi.
Doc, will answer that. Please come.
Maybe for me I'll answer that about maybe our son Oliza kwa mtandao. You know, with mental illnesses, you are either in relapse ama remission. Relapse basically means if you had a condition, maybe for example like bipolar, and then your bipolar iko affected maybe na unameza madawa, you're managing, you know, unamezi madawa, you're not managing it. Maybe for example, a trigger for bipolar can be drug use, because maybe drug kama maybe weed in affect maybe how the way you're managing your condition. So there's relapse ama remission. Remission basically means that you are no longer using your medication. You're using your medication, unaenda therapy, medical, una madawa pia unameza. So maybe remission ni uko sawa, but relapse bado inaweza happen. So that's why maybe kuna hiyo specific ya condition inaweza enda for the rest of your life. You have to be on drugs. If you're not, you relapse. Yeah, and maybe therapy na unaimanage pia na unaona mba daktari pia. Basically, that's just it.
Does it mean inakuanga immune kwa wase wengine na kuna wase wengine inakuwa na some repercussion for a lifetime?
When you say immune, like, what do you mean kusema immune?
Yani kuna wale wase wenye watatumia hizo drugs, lakini haziwa affect, but kuna wale wenye watatumia. Haziwa affect.
We jaribu hone.
Kusema ni drug kama gani, maybe, example ya drug?
Kaa sana kaa weed juu.
Okay, weed. Unajua weed iko na effects mingi na kwa akili ya binadamu basically there are chemicals in your brain. Na if a chemical imbalance is created, that's why unazoona hizo conditions kama hizo zenye tunaongelea bipolar, schizophrenia, kuna chemical imbalance. So kama kuna chemical imbalance kwa brain yako, obviously ukitumia weed weed imesha affect sasa create hiyo chemical imbalance. So obviously now uko na condition, and maybe sometimes pia maybe ulikuwa na condition maybe for instance like bipolar and haujawahi trigger, hujawahi tumia kitu itoe hiyo illness nje. What happens now umetumia bangs, so it trigger to your condition basically. That's what you've done. Yeah,
okay. Obina,
yeah.
Of course we saw that.